I'm Milaan Moses, and I'm originally from SoCal, specifically Riverside. I remember being in my first hip-hop class back in college, and it was a beginner's class, and I was like, this is what I've been missing, like that feeling, that drive, like rush you get from just like using every part of your body and feeling grounded. And so when I started doing hip-hop full-time here in March with the Skate Dance Academy, I remember our first performance at Juneteenth, and I was on stage, and I was like, this is what I have to do for the rest of my life. And it was just that particular style is just what really fueled my heart. A huge like inspiration in my life is my mom, because she got through so much. She's fully disabled, and she went through a lot in her life, and so like seeing the pride that she has in me when I dance just like lights her up, and so that makes like pushes me to do better and be a better dancer. When it's gloomy out, I like force myself to create almost, and to like get myself out of that. So like for a while it did like make creativity like go in a back hole, but I realized that's not who I am and that's not who I want to be. And so like it really pushes me now to find something and create light out of nothing, which I don't always have my best works from it, but I think having a repertoire of work is better than having nothing, and just it gets you to that point where one day you can be like, okay, I'm proud of that. In high school, where I went to a predominantly white school, and I was on the cheer team, where I was like maybe one of five people of color on this 180 person cheer team. You know, like we are massive, but even though there's so many of us, like I felt so few in the numbers, and it made me question my identity a lot, and made me question like, why was I chosen to have this skin color? Why was I chosen to have this life? I was like chosen for this, you know, kind of thing. And like, I think it's a lot of struggles that people of color tend to face when they're younger, especially in that type of community. And it's learning that as you get older, that you're beautiful and you're strong and you're powerful no matter who you are, but it takes a long time. And so for a long time, it made me think that I wasn't worthy of dance and I wasn't worthy of certain styles, but now it like, empowers me, because I think of like all the little girls like me that think, why should I have curly hair and why do I have the skin tone, and like, because you're perfect and you are strong enough to have those things and you're amazing and there's nothing that should stop you, no style should stop you, you're entitled to dance like everyone else and no one should see those things other than you as a dancer and as an artist and creator. I think that dancing is for everyone. People think you have to be good at it. People think you have to be training your whole life. People think you have to start young, especially in the industry. Doesn't matter the age, doesn't matter your body type, disabilities, abilities. Like, I think dancing is for everyone, and if you want to try it, you should do it. And I think live your truth, speak your truth is what it is at the end of the day, through dance, through whatever art you find.